What's up, guys? On today's episode, we're going to be learning how to do the Shotokan front kick. There's two ways of doing the Maigeri or front kick. There's a right way and a wrong way. And today, I'm going to show you guys some tricks on how to do it the correct way. So like that, you're always on target and you never get hurt. First things first, guys, here's what we have to do. Let's work on our balance because that's the number one priority when doing a good front kick. Remember, when you kick, you're gonna be on one leg. So balance is extremely important for you to have. Let's practice this. Knee up, toes up. We don't wanna keep those toes facing down. We wanna make sure our toes are always pointing to where we wanna go. Okay, so that's a good way of practicing a good chamber, how we like to call it. So here, knee up, toes up, bring it back down. Knee up, toes up, bring it back down. And that's actually the start of the front kick. All right, so from here, put your feet together. That's one way, good way to start, so you can always come back to that same position. Put your feet together, keep your back straight, and from here, I want to extend my foot straight out and bring it back. Extend your foot out, bring it back. Now notice that when I kick, I'm kicking with the ball of your foot, okay? So make sure we don't kick with the toes because you're gonna break your toes and you don't want that. I wanna make sure you guys kick with the ball of your foot. Not with the heel of your foot, but with the ball, okay? So again, it's like if you're, here's a good way to practice. Go on your ball of your foot on the floor. Pick up your heels off the floor. Okay, you're gonna pick up your heels off the floor and that's the part where you're gonna be kicking with. Okay, so your heel is not touching. When you kick, you're extending like if you're on your tippy toes going forward, okay? All right, so one way to practice. Toes together, we're gonna bring that foot straight out, bring it back, okay? So you notice that right from here. Feet out, make sure we don't kick around. Make sure we don't kick to the side. Make sure we aim that kick right to the center of the chest. So I'm here, right to the middle, nice and easy. Now remember, we don't wanna let that kick just die out. Here's what I mean. I don't want you guys to kick and then just let your leg flop down, okay? We wanna make sure that kick recovers or, like we like to call it, snaps back like a whip, okay? Again, I'm here, and then I put it down. So I go out, back, and then I put it down, okay? So let's try it out with both legs. Practice this at home, and that's one way of getting a good front kick. Toes together, all toes face forward, back is straight, kick to the middle. Kick to the middle. Now notice your knee comes up, and then it comes down. My knee comes up first, extend the foot, bring it back, put it back down, okay? So we go side to side, okay? We're here, one, two, three, four, and five. And that's one way that you guys can practice your front kick at home. Here's another great way of you practicing your front kick at home. Now, I have this box, it's about 20 inches high, which is about as tall as a regular chair, okay? So you guys can use a chair, a couch, a bed, it doesn't matter. The further you are away from the chair, from the obstacle, the easier it's gonna be. The closer you are, the harder it's gonna be, okay? So, here's what I want you guys to do. Let's bring it a little bit closer. I wanna put my feet together, and I wanna be able to kick over the obstacle without hitting it, or without letting that foot touch the obstacle, okay? So I'm here. I kick out and I bring it back. Kick out, bring it back. Kick out, bring it back. See how easy that is? Okay, but that helps you create that good chamber and that good snapback. Okay, because we also don't want to keep our feet out for too long. Okay, so if you want to make it a little bit harder, you want to work on those quads, let me show you guys. I'll bring it this way. Take your time, okay? Make each move for about 2 to 3 seconds, okay? So first move, one, two, extend. One, two, bring back. One, two, put it down. One, two, okay? So you see how that works? Again, I'm here, knee up, extend. Back, put it back down. And now, nice and easy, extend up. Notice how my knee comes all the way up. My knee comes all the way. Now, I touched it because I'm kind of close, all right? I'm making it really hard on myself, so I'm probably showing off for you guys. All right, so here we go. Right from here, one, two. You see, I extend that leg. Now, I don't wanna go into my leg this way. I wanna make sure I push forward and I come back. Push forward. Always aim right to the center. Go ahead, guys, and practice that as well. And that's gonna get your front kick extremely good. Let's bring my friend Bob out here because my friend Bob likes to get kicked a lot, okay? Now, if I'm gonna kick Bob right in the center of the chest or to the face, okay, I don't wanna kick him with the ball of my foot. I don't wanna kick him with my toes. If I kick him with my toes, that's gonna hurt. Your toes might break, okay? Especially if the other person's got some six pack or like a rock hard abs, okay? You don't wanna kick somebody with your toes, all right? Here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna kick him with the ball of the foot. So when I kick, notice that my heel is not touching, right? I'm not stomping it. It's not a stomp, okay? That becomes more of a push. I want you guys to snap your kick. Touch and bring it back. Touch and bring it back. Keep those toes up. Kick with the ball. One, two, three, four, five. Always toes up. It's not about power right now. It's all about your foot positioning. So make sure those toes are up and we kick right to the middle. Now, if you want to try it, you can try it with both feet side by side, or you can put one leg forward, one leg back, and start off with the back leg. You want to change the angle. You might even want to go with the front leg. Hit up, keeping one leg forward, hit up, back leg, hit up. Maybe step up front kick, right? Maybe jump front kick. I see, yes, there's different ways of performing the front kick, but you have to make sure that you understand your foot positioning and always hit with the bottom of the, with the ball of your foot, okay? So like that, if I wanna go to the face, I can always hit with the ball of the foot. Body, ball of the foot. Front leg, ball of the foot. Or the famous crane kick, ball of the foot, all right? So that's one way that I want you guys to practice that at home. Another way to practice your front kick is to go on your knees on the floor, okay? Put your knees on the floor, sit down on your knees. It's good if you have something soft like a yoga mat or a karate mat like these, okay? And you practice your snap. Here's what I wanna do. I wanna take one leg from the kneeling position. I wanna be able to kick out and bring it back. Kick out, bring it back. Kick out, bring it back. That forces you to snap that kick right back so nobody grabs it, okay? So you're here, hands up, try not to touch the floor. When you kick, good balance. Kick out, bring it back. Kick out, bring it back. Kick out, bring it back. Kick out, bring it back, all right? So that's one great way of you practicing your front kick at home. I hope you guys enjoy this, okay? And there's gonna be a lot more techniques where this came from, where you guys can learn the proper Shotokan technique. It's been great hanging out with you guys again. Now go out there, practice those kicks. Make sure you have good form, good technique. So like that, a good technique will never allow you to get hurt. And always keep your self-defense at top shape. All right, guys. I'll see you guys on the next one. Bye, guys.